Great Wall of Dallas, Part 2. We're highlighting today Mark Stepnoski, number 53, a center for the Dallas Cowboys. For at least two of their Super Bowl runs, he was their center. Mark Stepnoski, date of birth, January the 20th, 1967. Place of birth was Pennsylvania. Now let's kind of look at his early years or high school years. Stepnoski was a highly recruited All-State, a parade, All-American, offensive tackle from Cathedral High School. He graduated in 1985. He signed with the University of Pittsburgh, became a four-year starter as an offensive guard, helping clear the way for Craig Hayward and Kervin Richards to become one of the two leading rushers in the nation. Stepnoski was a third-team All-American as a sophomore, a first-team All-American in 1988, one of the three finalists for the Outland Trophy as a senior. He was a two-time academic All-American, 1986 and 1988, played in the East-West Shrine Bowl. His play earned him a spot on his home state All-Century second team by the Pennsylvania Football News. Now, his professional career. Stepnoski was selected by the Dallas Cowboys in the third round in 1989 NFL Draft. He dropped in draft because the scouts thought he was undersized for the NFL. The Cowboys switched him to center, although he had never played the position. During his rookie year, he was tutored by Tom Rafferty, and I'll show you a picture of Tom Rafferty. Some of you longtime Cowboy fans will remember him. He was, through the years of Tom Landry, blocked for some great running backs, such as Tony Dorsett, Herschel Walker, blocked for Roger Staubach and Danny White, some of the great, great quarterbacks in Cowboy history. So he was being tutored by Tom Rafferty, who was playing his last season in the NFL. It says about Mark Stepnoski, he became a starter for the last four games of the season. Stepnoski used his athletic ability, leverage, and balance to outmaneuver the bigger defensive players, became one of the league's best centers of the era. By the end of 1991 season, he was selected to the first of five straight Pro Bowls. From 92 to 94, together with Eric Williams, Mark Tuinei, Nate Newton, Kevin Grogan, he was a part of some of the best offensive line play in the NFL history that also helped pave the way for Emmitt Smith to become the NFL all-time leading rusher. In 1993, he suffered a knee injury that required surgery while playing against Minnesota Vikings in the 13th game of the season. He was replaced by Dallas great John Gesick and couldn't play during the playoffs in the Super Bowl 28. He became a free agent at the end of the season, but the Cowboys could only sign him to a one-year contract, $1.2 million and a $500,000 signing bonus. Stepnoski was one of the team's first big-name players to leave the Cowboys following the 1994 season via unrestricted free agency, leaving with three Pro Bowls and back-to-back Super Bowl victories. He signed with the Houston Oilers in 1995, which later became the Tennessee Oilers in 1997. During his four seasons with the Oilers, he continued his streak of success, making the Pro Bowl twice. And he comes back to Dallas for his second stint. The Cowboys signed Stepnoski as a free agent in 1999, where he finished his career with three more solid years, retiring after the 2001 season. Stepnoski played 13 years in the NFL, including five consecutive Pro Bowl appearances and a place on the National Football League 1990s All-Decade Second Team. In November of 2007, Stepnoski expressed support for the 9/11 Truth Movement, which I also do too. This is a little clip from the, let me move this back a little bit, from the Alex Jones show. I don't know all what happened in 9/11, but there was definitely something that doesn't all line up. And this is Mark Stepnosky on the Alex Jones show.
Rooting for Mark, and now I'm rooting for him in a much more important way, and that is his courage speaking out for 9/11 truth. There's a ballot initiative in New York to get a new investigation going or expose that, a grand jury. There's a lot of different initiatives. There's marches going on, events coming up in New York next week that I hope folks go to. And let's talk about that ballot initiative first, and then I want to get into the NIST report, Mark.
Yeah, obviously, you know, since we're coming up on the anniversary of 9/11, there's a lot of activities going around to highlight the fact that the official story is untrue. One of those is in New York City. It's a 9/11 ballot initiative. This is a way for, I mean, it's obvious that, like I said earlier, that we're not going to get a proper investigation through government channels. But this is a way for the people of New York City to create a new 9/11 commission, an investigation of the events, which would have subpoena power. It would have some legal authority. Volunteers in New York City have been going around getting signatures on petitions. They needed a minimum of 30,000, which they just recently achieved. So that was great news. And now these petitions will be submitted to the New York City clerk and New York City Council. And with a sufficient amount of signatures, this being above 30,000, they will be able to present this, and then it can become an issue, a topic on the ballot. I believe it would be part of the 2009 ballot for mayor, the election of mayor in New York City, where citizens can vote for themselves. They can make their voices heard that they think it is necessary as citizens of that city.
Anyways, that's on YouTube, and you can watch that anytime you would like. But to end this little segment of Mark Stepnosky, part of the Great Wall of Dallas, it goes, he's also an advocate of marijuana, which I'm not a big advocate of marijuana, but anyways, I do agree with him much on the 9/11 truth movement. But it goes on to say about Mark Stepnosky, his Catholic school kind of pretty much removed him from the Hall of Fame. He went to a Catholic high school, so they removed his name from the Hall of Fame, or the High School Hall of Fame, or whatever you want to call it. And it says, for that same reason, he immigrated to Canada. So he's, at this present of this information, the present time, he was in Canada, which I don't necessarily, that's not a bad thing either. So, but anyways, join me next time for part 3, Nate Newton, The Great Wall of Dallas.